I'm Kevin Kelly. I'm Senior Maverick at Wired Magazine. There's a lot happening in the world, and especially in the world of technology. The things that I'm most excited by these days is the cognification of everything. That means putting little tiny bits of intelligence in everything we make, from my clothes to my shoes, to windows, to light bulbs, to doorways, to cars. Some things will have a little bit of intelligence, some will have a lot of intelligence. Everything that we have already automated, everything that we have already electrified, we're now going to cognify. We're now going to add intelligence to. And this intelligence is going to flow like electricity to everywhere on a grid, which we call the cloud. And so you will buy or use as much AI as you want to. You just purchase it, just like you buy electricity. And this new power is what's going to propel the second industrial revolution. It's going to change most work. Most work is a bundle of different little tasks. A lot of those tasks are repetitive. Those repetitive tasks go to the AIs and the robots. So anything where efficiency counts is given to the bots. That leaves us humans with the tasks that are inefficient. And we're very good at being inefficient. Inefficiency is actually the foundation of science and innovation. You have to make mistakes. You have to try things that don't work. You have to do things that are dead end. Exploration, discovery, art, human experiences are all inherently inefficient. I think the result of all these changes is that on average, more people of the world will have their basic needs met. The shelter, food, clothing, education, which will allow more people of the world to try and pursue their dreams. And on average, people will live longer, stay healthier, be safer, be better educated, have more rights. This advent of the new technology will increase our ability to try and redefine who we are, to invent our own new job, to invent new things that we want, to invent new ways of satisfying those wants. What we get out of all this is increasing choices and possibilities. And that's what we're going to be looking for into the next 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 years.